So this is the back of the bottle. It says, this vegan, light and creamy Spanish liqueur brings delicate, sweet, mild flavors of tig nuts, spice and citrus. And it's bottled in Cartagena in Spain. So it does actually remind me properly of the horchata de chufa, which is a Spanish drink they usually have cold during summer. The bottle's quite pretty. See, it's got a nice little, you know, little decoration, probably something Alhambra-like. So what do you think?
You can really taste the spice in it. It's very pungent with the spice. I can taste the cinnamon is the first thing you'll notice.
Well, for me, when I first tasted horchata, it did taste like almonds. So
I can't taste any citrus in it though. Like, it's not like there's a lemon or an orange or a mandarin.
It's more of a sweet one, maybe more a bergamot taste. So shall we add milk to it and see if it's like Bailey's in a way? Because the thing about Bailey's is very sweet. I find Bailey's rather sweet for my taste, just a bit. So I think it's worked out just over ice.
The straight would be better. I don't know how to go with milk.
Yeah, it's not really much of a cocktail, is it?
No, it's not like Bailey's, which is more of a mixer. This is a standalone.
Yeah, standalone, because it's horchata. What do you think? Does it improve?
It just gives it more volume. More volume than anything. It doesn't actually give it... it doesn't change the flavour.
Yeah, I think it just dilutes the alcohol, doesn't it?
It just basically, it's like adding, watering down any spirit. It just sort of doesn't change it. It just waters it down.
I wonder if different types of milk, maybe almond milk or soy milk, might change it.
Possibly. But I mean, at the end of the day, if you mixed up similar to Bailey's or something, you might, I don't know, you'd have to experiment.
Okay, so out of 10, what do we think?
I give it a 7. Mm-hmm. I actually enjoy the cinnamon taste. It's sort of like
a pie.
No, like actually chewing on a cinnamon stick.
Okay, well for me, I'll give it one more. So I'll give it an 8 out of 10, just because it does taste like the horchata I've had before. So alcoholic style with 16% volume. Really,
It is actually quite nice. Yeah, I mean, look, you wouldn't sit down and knock over a whole bottle.
No, but it's a good digestif, I think, like after a meal.
Oh, look, have something just sit around outside, and as you were saying beforehand, it was more of a
cool summer drink.
A cool summer thing.
Wonder if we can put it into coffee. I'm not sure. I mean, would you?
I mean,
put
it looks
coffee?
It's
like
one of those,
a Bailey's type.
It'd definitely be something you could sit outside and on the veranda with a bit of a sort of breeze and sort of. Mm. But a glass, you wouldn't. Absolutely get hammered with it.
Yeah, so I got the horchata from Dan Murphy's, good old Danny Murphy's, for $50. So it isn't bad. So it's a good substitution for the verbena liqueur I couldn't find, or the gentian liqueur I couldn't find from the Massif Central. So I've gone back to Spain and I've had the horchata instead. So I think it's a good substitute.
I can actually taste better by itself. Forget adding anything to it, like the milk didn't really do it much good. That's just a perfect taste. I still can't taste any of the citrus.
Yeah.
Oh. No.
Okay.
I can taste a lot of the spices, cinnamon and...
I could taste the citrus a bit.
Can you? I can taste spice.
But
it's sort
me,
of like
it tastes more like almond.
Like in your mince pie.
Yeah. Okay. You and your mince pie.
Mince pies.
All right. Bye for now, Mr. Me.
Bye.
Enjoy. Drink.
Responsibly.
Bye.
Bye.